In this video, we will learn how you can add a new subscriber list into your Pabbly email marketing account. To add a subscriber list, all you need to do is click on Add Subscribers. You can also click the Subscribers menu item right here. So I'm just clicking on Add Subscribers button right here. As you can see, we have several lists already created inside this account, but to create a new list, you can just click on Create New List button. Once you do that, an email list with a specific title of List 1 will automatically be created. If you want to change the name, you can change this to anything that you like. So I'm just writing a demo email list import. Okay. And just so that it is on the top, I'm just writing 01. Because that way it will be on the top. So I just wrote 01 demo email list import update. So an email list with this specific name is already created now. In my next step, I'm going to add new subscribers to this specific email list. To import your subscribers, we offer two different ways to do that. One is you can import subscribers in a very large amount using a CSV file, which you can easily create using your spreadsheet software or a Google Sheet software or any Microsoft Excel type of software. You also have an option to add emails manually, where you can just copy and paste the list of emails right here and those emails will automatically be imported. So in the first method, I'm going to give you the demo of how you can import a list of CSV file, list of your subscribers using a CSV file. So I'm just clicking on import from a CSV file. We also offer a way where you can download a sample file by clicking on this button so that you can see the format of the sample file. So I'm just opening that sample file so that you can see the format. The format of the sample file says that the first column can be name, another column can be email. If you have any custom data, you can include a custom header right here. This is custom 1, this is custom 2, and this is custom 3. You can include all the datas related to this specific heads in individual lines. So the name is FormGet, the email is this, the custom data is office, the custom 1 is this data, and this data, and this data. So based on this specific sheet, I've actually created a sample CSV file, and I will be showing you how you can import this CSV file in this video. So I'm moving to a spreadsheet software. I'm using Google Sheet for this specific example. As you can see, I have added my headers right here. It says name, it says email, city, and gender. The name is Neeraj Agrawal, the email address is right here, the city name is right here, and the gender is also included in this email list. If you don't have any specific data for any specific user, you can simply ignore that specific data and still the list will import fine. You don't have to worry about that. So once your email list is created right here and your entire data is within the sheet, you can go to file from your spreadsheet software and you can click on download and you can use the comma separated values, the .csv of the current sheet. Okay. Similarly, in Excel, you can also download the comma separated value file. In this option, Google Sheet, you can do by going to files and download. So I'm going to click on this and you can see my Pabbly emails to import sheet has been downloaded. Now I am going back to the Pabbly email marketing software. I'm clicking on the choose file. Okay. And in fact, what you can do is you can simply drag and drop the file right here. In fact, that is not possible. So what I'm doing is I'm going to click on choose. I'm going to click on my finder, which says the recent file. I'm going to choose the sample import.csv file. In fact, that is not the file that I want to download. The file is stored in my downloads. It says the Pabbly emails to import sheet1.csv and I can open that file. Once this file is selected, I'm just clicking on import subscribers button. Once I do that, it says whether the first row is your header. I'm saying yes, my first row is my header. This means this row does not contain my data. This is my header row. Okay. Name, it is asking me for all the tags where I want to store the name. I am selecting name here. It says email address. I am selecting the email address. It says the city. I am selecting the city. It also says gender. So currently, as you can see, my gender custom field is not created right here. So what I'm doing right now is I'm just selecting a custom data field right here to import this file. Once I do that, I'm just clicking on import subscribers button. It says, please wait, we are importing your list. And then it says that your subscriber list is imported successfully. I'm just clicking on OK button. And you can see the demo email list import file has been uploaded. It says the email address, it mentions the name, it mentions the gender, it mentions the city, and it also mentions the subscribe rate on which I have imported this contact. So currently, when you have imported this file, you have seen that the tag here is the custom tag that I used. If you really want to add any new tags, any new custom tags, you can just click on this specific three button point right here. And you can click on custom fields from this specific menu. From this specific menu, you can add a new custom field. So in this case, I am adding a gender custom field. This means a gender custom field has already automatically created. If you want to include any gender tag anywhere, you can simply use this tag and the gender of that specific person will automatically be included in the email campaigns that you sent. Okay. So as you can see, the subscribers are created, the demo list is imported, and the subscribers have been added as well using the CSV file that we imported right here. Now I'm going to import one more contact, but this time I'm going to add the contact by manually using the copy and paste system. So I'm clicking on add subscribers. I'm saying that I want to add emails manually. And then I'm going to write the name of the tag that I want to use here. Okay. So I'm just going to add name and email. So I just wrote name and email. So the name of this person is Pankaj Agrawal. The email address is pankajgunnar000@gmail.com. If you have any specific custom field that you want to use, you can just use the custom tag right here. And then you can say mail, that's it. If you want to add one more contact, you can say ronpeters@gmail.com, and he's also mail. So as you can see, I added two different data. If you want to add these two different fields in a gender tab, you can just use the gender right here, and you can see that a new custom field gender will now appear in this specific list item as well. And those subscriber will be added to those specific gender tab. Okay. So I wrote two different data. If you don't have any specific data for any specific person, you can just leave this blank and our system will automatically detect that this specific data does not exist for this person. So I just wrote two different data. I'm again clicking on import subscribers. We again got a system where it is asking, where do I have to store the name? Where do I have to store the email? And where do I have to store the gender? If you really want to store gender in the custom tab, you can do that. But now you can see the gender tab is also, the gender custom field is also appearing right here. So you can also select this. Since I have uploaded the rest of the male, female genders in the custom field with the name of custom, I'm just using the same field right here. After choosing this, I'm clicking on import subscribers, and the import subscriber has been imported successfully. You can see the subscriber count increased to 6 now. And you can see that the PankajGunnar000 has appeared right here. Within the custom tab, we have this specific person. Within the custom tab, we have this person added as well. Since we have not used the city custom field, it is not appearing right here. So I hope you totally understood that how we can add subscriber using both the methods, how you can add subscriber using the CSV file, and how you can add subscriber manually using copying and pasting the entire email list within this specific section. I hope you found this video useful to add new subscribers to the Pabbly email marketing account. You can also do, you can also create the custom fields which I showed you right here. I will be explaining custom fields in a separate video as well. Now we also have segmentation option, we also have a list cleaning option, we also have lots of different options that you can be you can use right here. So I will be explaining those options in separate videos. So thank you for watching this video. If you have any issues in uploading your email list, just email us or get in touch with our support through the live chat button right here. So thank you.